Hello students, welcome to the English video class. Today we are going to deal with parts of speech. What are parts of speech? They refer to a class of words based on their function and the way they work in a sentence. There are 8 parts of speech. As you have already know all these things, once again
I remind you,
what are they? Noun, adjective, verb, adverb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. How a word is used in a sentence determines its part of speech. Understood clearly? How a word is used in a sentence determines its part of speech. Because one word may act as preposition as well as conjunction. Okay, just a recollection. What is noun? Nouns are words that name people, places, things, animals, or ideas. For example, people. Who are people? Group of individuals. For example, Richard. Richard is a name of the person. Richard is the name of a person. Then, India. What is India? It refers to a country, that is place. Then, for example, book is the name of a thing. Likewise, you can give many proper nouns. What are the 5 basic types of nouns? Can you tell me? Yes. Common noun, proper noun, abstract noun, collective noun, and concrete noun. These are the basic types. Apart from these types, we can also have countable nouns, uncountable nouns, compound nouns, singular nouns, plural nouns, as well as possessive nouns. Next, we are going to see about adjective. What is adjective? A word which modifies noun or pronoun. It enhances the impact of noun or pronoun. That is, it qualifies noun. For example, adjective modifying noun. Large elephant, empty house. It qualifies the noun. How was the elephant? It was large. How was the house? It was empty. Then, adjective modifying pronoun. He is brave. They are good students. Here, he and they are pronouns. Next, verb. What is verb? A verb denotes an action, feeling, or being a subject. What is a subject here? Noun. A verb denotes an action, feeling, or being a subject. Examples for verbs. The train moves. The guest arrived yesterday. He received his gift. Here, moves, arrived, and received are verbs. They denote action. Actions of the noun. What is the importance of verb? Can you tell me? Yes. The verb plays a role of backbone of the sentence. The verb plays the role of backbone of a sentence. Without a verb, we can never complete a sentence. See, for example, likewise, you recollect all the parts of speech and it is given in your book, page number 39. You all take page number 39. Can you see a tabular column given there? Yes. It is given word with meaning and its part of speech. Example for that word, it is given a sentence and we have to convert into another part of speech. For that part of speech, it is given a sentence. One is done for your reference. For the remaining things, I will tell you the sentence and I will help you. Okay, take it down. Second one, it is given word harm. Meaning of the word harm is hurt. And its part of speech is
noun.
So now we are going to write a sentence with the word harm. Are you all taking down? Example for harm is, she will do anything to protect her children from harm. She will do anything to protect her children from harm. How we can change it into another part of speech? We can change harm into harmful. That is adjective. Shall we write a sentence with adjective? Yes. Fruit juices can be harmful to children's teeth. Come to the next one. It is given stimulate. The meaning for stimulate is induce. Its part of speech is verb. Example for stimulate. Their discussion stimulated him. How we can convert this word into another part of speech? Stimulate is verb. What is the noun form for this word? Stimulation. Yes, you are right. For example, his apathy necessitates stimulation. Come to the next one. What is the word given there? Argue. Meaning of argue is oppose. And what is its parts of speech? Verb. Yes. Shall we write the sentence? Let's not argue about it. It is always easy to convert verb from noun. So what is the noun form for argue? Argument. His argument did not convince his opponents. What is the next word? Strong. What do you mean by strong? Yes, powerful. What is its part of speech? Adjective. Because strong is a quality. Example, I will choke it with my strong arms. What is its noun form? Yes, strength. Good. Example, you can say the famous proverb. Yes, you are right. Union is strength. And the last word is destroy. Meaning of destroy is demolish. And what is its part of speech? Yes, verb. Shall we write the sentence?
Bad habits destroy our future.
What is the noun form for this word? Yes, destruction.
And its example is, the war brought death and destruction.
Now, I hope you understand how to write the sentence with the parts of speech. Shall we go to the next part of speech? Conjunction. It is given in your book page number 46 and 47. What are conjunctions? What are the kinds of conjunctions and their functions? And sample sentences and exercises. These are all the things we are going to deal now. What is conjunction? Con plus junction. Con means together and junction means joining. So, what is the meaning of the word conjunction? Joining together. It joins two sentences into one. What is conjunction? A word that connects or joins words, phrases, clauses or sentences. Understand clearly, a word that connects or joins words, phrases, clauses or sentences. There are three main kinds of conjunctions. What are they? Coordinating conjunction, correlative conjunction and subordinating conjunction. Let's see one by one. What is coordinating conjunction? It is used to connect similar parts of speech or group of words of same grammatical category. The key words for coordinating conjunctions are fanboys. What is fanboys? It is a clue for you to remember easily. Let's see the expansion for fanboys. F for A and, N nor, B but, O or, Y yet, yes so. Can you remember easily? Yes. The keywords for coordinating conjunctions is fanboys. Let's see the examples. How the coordinating conjunctions come with nouns and pronouns. Example is, Alex and I attended the lecture. How the coordinating conjunctions come with verbs? See, for example, our dog whined and scratched at the door. Now with adjectives. Example is, the coconut was tender, large, yet tasteless. Next with adverbs. Example is, the man responded quickly but incorrectly. Now with prepositional phrases. Example is, I will go to Greece or to Spain. Then with complete ideas. He seemed distressed, so we discussed his problem. Now, shall we go to the correlative conjunctions? Yes. What are correlative conjunctions? They are working in pairs. They join elements of same grammatical category in sentences in much the same manner as coordinating conjunctions do. Have you understood clearly? What are correlative conjunctions? They are working in pairs. They join elements of same grammatical category in sentences in much the same manner as coordinating conjunctions do. The key words for correlative conjunctions are both and, either or, neither nor, not only but also, whether or. See, these are not different words. They will come as pairs in correlative conjunctions. They are related with one another. We cannot separate them. That's why they are called correlative conjunctions. Let's see the examples. How the correlative conjunctions come with nouns. Example, both the employers and the employees agree. Then with nouns and pronouns. Call either Surya or me if you need help. Then we are going to see the example with prepositional phrases. Put the check either in the drawer or beside the telephone. Then with adjectives. The example is, the rain was not only heavy but also cold. Then we are going to move to subordinating conjunction. What is subordinating conjunction? It joins two clauses or ideas by making one of the ideas subordinate to or dependent upon the other. Understand clearly? Subordinating conjunction joins two clauses or ideas by making one of the ideas subordinating to or dependent upon the other. Let's see the keywords for subordinating conjunction. There are more words. You take it one by one. After, although, as long as soon as, because, before, even if, even though, how, if, in order that, now that, since, so that, then, that, though, till, unless, until, when, whenever, where, wherever, while. Have you noted down? And what is subordinating conjunction? One more idea to understand clearly. The subordinate idea in a sentence always begins with the subordinating conjunction and makes up what is known as a subordinate clause. Once again, I repeat. The subordinate idea in a sentence always begins with the subordinating conjunction and makes up what is known as a subordinate clause. See here, some conjunctions also function as prepositions. You should not confuse. That's why I have told in the beginning itself, parts of speech is nothing but how the word comes in a sentence. See, for examples, after, before, since, till, until. These words act as conjunctions and also as prepositions. So, you should not confuse with the words. See, some conjunctions also function as adverbs. Write those words. after, before, when, where. Some conjunctions also function as prepositions or adverbs. See here, only the word before act as subordinating conjunction, preposition and also adverb. Let's see one by one. How the word before acts as subordinating conjunction. For example, think carefully before you choose. Think carefully before you choose. Next one, before acts as preposition. Example, we will finish the project before October. We will finish the project before October. Then with adverb. I had met him once before. I had met him once before. Some conjunctions also function as prepositions or adverbs. See, for example, now we have seen the example with the word before. Now we are going to see the examples with the word after. First one, subordinating conjunction. How the word after acts as subordinating conjunction, preposition as well as adverb. First, we are going to see with subordinating conjunction. Example is, after you had left, I got a phone call from John. Then with preposition. I went for a swim after breakfast. I went for a swim after breakfast. Then with adverb. He died on June 1st and was buried the day after. You have to remember, prepositions and conjunctions function in sentences as connectors. Have it in your mind and understand clearly. Prepositions and conjunctions function in sentences as connectors. Subordinating conjunctions, prepositions and adverbs. The same word acts as subordinating conjunctions, prepositions and adverbs. Let's see the examples. Before we planted seeds, we fertilized the garden. You have to identify to which part of speech it belongs. I have never done this before. Have you taken down? I have never done this before. The third one is, I want to do this before Monday. I want to do this before Monday. Some more tasks for you. You have to identify whether it is subordinating conjunction, preposition or adverb. Where are you going? Where are you going? Next one. Their job is to go where they are called. Their job is to go where they are called. The last one. He is looking for a house where he can have peace. He is looking for a house where he can have peace. Can you identify the part of speech? Okay. I hope you can identify. Have you enjoyed the class? Have you understood clearly? Yes. Thank you.
இந்நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி சிறப்பு அலுவலர் கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி 8ஆம் தளம் அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம் காந்தி மண்டப சாலை கோட்டூர்புரம் சென்னை 685 தொலைபேசி எண் 7824015000